Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to my Atlanta Braves franchise mode series here in MLB The Show 16 on the PS4. We are about done with the month of May. Once we turn the calendar, we've got a big series coming up with the Washington Nationals, but before we do that, we are on the verge of the MLB first year player draft. Now, last year, there were mixed reactions on how I did with the draft. A lot of you said, worst draft ever, that kind of things. How can you be building and rebuilding a team if you can't draft? Well, I took a lot of that to heart. I still don't know if I'm doing this exactly how you would do it, but I feel like I got some pretty good prospects out here if you're going by the potential of what we actually hauled in. The catcher was a little bit of a reach, but we needed that position. But we get good potential, especially in the way of starting pitching, as our second round pick is actually a 94 in potential. I think the first one was 83. Anyway, we find ourselves early on here in the season in first place as we're about to take on the Nationals, who are in second place. For a rebuilding team to have a first place showdown, I don't care any point in the year, that's pretty exciting for this young team. So let's see how the Braves do here at Turner Field hosting the Nationals. Can they win this series and remain in first place in the division? There's Bryce Harper and Freddie Freeman posing for the cameras before we get started. But now it is time to play some ball. On the mound today, Sean Newcomb. Two wins, one loss. We've brought him up here and let him get after it in the major leagues. Hopefully he can continue to blossom here in the show. Now there's a strikeout of Bryce Harper, so you don't want to take that lightly. He's able to get the slugger and retire the side in the inning. We'll go to the bottom of the first now, and that's Juan Lagares. Fair ball down the left field line. He's going to lead off the game for the Braves with a hit. He'll stay right there at first base and see what can be done behind him in the order. So we go a couple batters in, and you got Freddie Freeman coming up to the plate now with two outs. He is fourth in the National League in batting average, and he's settling in for his first at bat of the game. He is able to drill this. He gets it up in the air. It's deep, and it is gone. First inning, two-run jack. Puts his Braves in the lead 2-0. Great way to start this game here when they're taking on their division foe and battling for first place. Get the crowd behind you right away. And it definitely sounds like they're rocking and rolling here at Turner Field. So the eighth home run of the season for Freddie Freeman goes 387 feet. It drives in two, and the Braves have that first inning lead. He gets back to the dugout and finds a nice reception here by his teammates. They're all fired up to start this series. And amongst the celebration here, let's roll the replay of the two-run homer. Freeman is able to get great bat extension, get that bat around, and drill it to right center field and gone. So still in the first inning, you got Trace Thompson up now, and he is going to hit the ball fairly well. Center field, it is back. Can he make a catch here? No, it's going to be off the wall. Thompson already at second, rounding, going to third. He'll easily have a triple here. So he follows up the home run by Freeman by getting to third base. Okay, two-out rally in full effect by the Braves. Trace Thompson, the latest. That looked like a mistimed jump there, maybe. But one way or another, Trace Thompson ends up at third, looking to be knocked home here. And it's Dansby Swanson coming to the plate. He will try to get an RBI here. As you see, he's had a nice start to his season, his official rookie season. He broke in last year but did not qualify to break that rookie status. And now that is a hit to center. The dive, and he couldn't come up with it. It's all the way to the fence. Swanson around second, going to third. He is not going to stop there. They're waving him. The throw to the plate is offline. It's an inside-the-park home run for Dansby Swanson. My, oh my, it's 4-0. In the first inning, two home runs, one over the fence and one inside the park in this inning to highlight the Braves' first inning outburst. As you see Swanson dashing to the plate, and there's not even a play there as he is safe. So we now fast forward to the top of the fourth inning, and the Nationals down 4-0, but that is up the middle. Base hit, runner going to come around and try to score. Strong throw to the plate, but it's not in time. The tag is late, and the Nationals get their first run of the game. It's 4-1 as Zimmerman drives home a run. But that is all they'll get in the inning. We go to the bottom of the inning now, in the bottom of the fourth, and that's Echevarria getting a base hit up the middle on two strikes, hanging in there, not giving up his at-bat, and getting on base. So that brings up Tyler Flowers to the plate, and the 1-1 pitch is crushed to left. It is deep, it is back, and it is gone. The third Braves home run of the day, only the second to leave the ballpark. Tyler Flowers makes it 6-1 with the home run to left, and the Braves seem to be in control of this one in the early innings. Yeah, that is his third of the season. It goes 394 feet. Definitely has Sean Newcomb fired up there as he awaits his turn to bat. 394 feet is the home run as you see this fly out off the bat of Tyler Flowers. See you later, 6-1 Braves, and that is going to be see you later for the starting pitcher as well. He just did not have it. Ross will be pulled and sent to the showers early. So now we go to the top of the sixth inning. Runner on third base, and well, he is going to score with that single. It's now a 6-2 ball game as Newcomb gets roughed up again by Zimmerman coming through with his second RBI of the game. Okay, well, that's not a big deal, but you got two runners on here with two outs, and Daniel Murphy connects. It's deep, and it is gone into the bullpen area. Three-run homer, and all of a sudden, it's a one-run game, 6-5. Newcomb cannot be happy with what he just served up right there. Murphy's eighth of the season, 402 feet. Just about pegged a reliever out in the bullpen. As we need to see a replay of this, pitches up a little higher than he wanted it, going, attempting to get that low in the zone, and well, it doesn't get past Murphy whatsoever. He cranks it and makes this game very uncomfortable for the Braves all of a sudden, 6-5. Newcomb still in the game, and he gets a comebacker to the mound. He'll throw over to first base. The inning finally over, but the Nationals have come roaring right back. So now we have Quackenbush pitching. Newcomb's out of here, and he comes up with a strikeout of Zimmerman in a big spot. He's all fired up as he goes back to the dugout here, keeping that 6-5 lead intact for the Braves. As you see the reaction right there to the strikeout. Yes, there he goes. He keeps it right where it's at. So trying to tack on more in the bottom of the seventh. That's hit hard by Josh Harrison, but right at the shortstop. And that will end the Braves' threat in the seventh. Let's go to the top of the eighth, and that's Matt Wieters hitting, and he definitely beats the shift right here, and he beats it in a big way. He's going to be able to walk to second base by the time they track this down. So the catcher comes through, just puts the bat on the ball the opposite way where nobody is, and he has himself a double, trying to become the tying run. He's now in scoring position as you see this thing getting through, and he's all fired up trying to get his teammates to follow suit here and drive him home. So 3-2 count with two outs, one pitch away from getting out of the inning, but that's not what's going to happen. That's into the gap, and it will be an RBI double. We are all tied at six. Sean Newcomb's day completely done now. He cannot win this game. Of course, he cannot lose it either. He will get a no decision, but we want to try to win this thing. Bottom of the eighth, Dansby Swanson hit the inside the park homer earlier. Now he gets his bat broken, and the pop-up is caught easily. Inning over. We take this into extra innings, into the top of the 10th. Still tied, 6-6, when this ball is launched to right center field. Wieters had the double. Now he's got a home run that'll put the Nationals ahead 7-6. Oh, that sinking feeling. He had a 6-1 lead. It is evaporated, and now it's a 7-6 deficit. Wieters' seventh home run of the season, 404 feet, and the crowd goes silent as the Braves now trail in extra innings after this long fly reaches the seats. They actually tack on two more and make this 9-6, making a comeback very improbable in the 10th inning. They got a runner on, though, but Conforto, who did not have a hit in the game, grounds into a double play, and just like that, they have two outs in the ninth. Josh Harrison in the batter's box trying to extend the ball game, 2-1 count, and he hits it in the air. But unless this gets over the fence, this game is over, and that's exactly what happens. It's caught, And the game is over. The one that got away here to the Nationals, as the Braves have a frustrating collapse and lose the game 9-6. The Nationals gain some confidence, gain a victory, and get themselves right back in the first place picture here in the division. Matt Wieters goes 4-for-5 with the home run, the double, and he is your player of the game. So we lose the first game of the series here against the Nationals, and then we lose something much bigger. In the second game of the series, Julio Teheran suffers a concussion and is going to be out 3 to 4 weeks. Oh no, we just lost our number one starter. That is going to be hard to replace. We go down to the minors here. We're going to grab Aaron Blair and give him a shot to come up. Not that he's really meant to be the ace of our staff, but we're going to have to plug him right in here after putting him on the 40-man roster and calling him up. We'll have to put him right here in Julio Teheran's space so that we can keep turning over this rotation, but not exactly what we had envisioned coming into the season here. Sean Newcomb already up from the minors, doing pretty well. He's up and down, obviously, as we saw in that start, and now you're depending on another kid to come in and take your ace's spot. This might be troubling. We'll see how the Braves deal with it next time.
Thanks for watching videos here on SGU. Go ahead and subscribe on YouTube at Sports Gaming Universe. Follow me on Twitter at NotusFan for all the latest info. And go ahead and check out that official Facebook page as well. Looking for SGU merchandise? SportsGamingUniverse.Spreadshirt.com is a place. All summer long, I'm partnering with FanDuel to bring you some fun daily fantasy sports action. Go to FanDuel.com/SportsGamingUniverse. And use the promo code SGU to get a free entry into a 50-50 league. That's FanDuel.com/SportsGamingUniverse.